Hi, everyone. Today we're talking about saving the first draft of history, also known as archiving. It's an issue the news industry and others have been grappling with for years, and it's not getting any easier. The digital revolution has meant new forms of content that need to be saved, and new pressures on how to save even some of the basics like text and photos. Helping folks understand the value of saving their content is one way to boost digital archiving. RJI fellow Neil Mara has been delving into that subject. Neil, who retired from his role as technology manager for McClatchy Newspapers, knows all about the tension points around archiving. Thanks for joining us today, Neil.
Well, thank you, Randy. It's great to be here talking about this very important issue.
So first question, what were you hoping to accomplish with your project and this report?
Randy, the key thing I was looking to do is to provide some incentives for newsrooms to reinvest in their news archives. What we learned through this research and others is that newsrooms have let go of a lot of their resources, both people and technology systems that used to be the heart of news preservation. And so the point here was to bring great examples from around the industry of the value that newsrooms are gaining from their archives. Value to do things like provide readers and listeners and viewers with perspective on today's news, to benefit financially from access to archives.
I think maybe archiving has been, you know, taken for granted a little bit, but why do you think it has taken a bit of a back seat in the industry?
It's really connected to the overall difficulties that the news industry has been facing over the past decade and more. With the shift to digital, there have been cutbacks in the resources that traditionally have been used for news preservation. We've got layoffs in newsrooms across the country, newsrooms that are really a fraction of their former size. And so I think that's really one of the problems, because the experts who would have been there to help guide the transition to digital archiving really haven't been there.
With all the information that you gathered, what do you see ahead for archiving?
There's several things going on. For one, I think, you know, there's really no easy way out of this. But the newsrooms that are the most forward-looking, I think, are actually beginning to respond. One of the things they're responding to are new forces in digital news production that I think are actually eventually going to move the needle on this issue. And it's really because of the need for good digital asset management. This is quickly becoming an essential part of digital publishing. They need access to the original versions of digital news assets. Not the versions that went on a website or in a web CMS, because those have already been dumbed down for web purposes, for speed, for example. And I think news organizations are coming to recognize that more and more.
For more information about Neil's project and to download his full report, you can visit our website, rjionline.org. And thank you for joining us today.